Hi students, welcome to Masterclass channel. Today we are going to discuss about possible MCQ type questions comes under EC8553 discrete time signal processing unit 1. Let us enter into the session. First question, the discrete time functions defined as U of n equal to n. For n greater than or equal to 0, then one more condition is also given, that is u of n equal to 0 for n less than 0 is a dash. Option A, unit sample signal. Option B, unit step signal. Option C, unit ramp signal. Option D, none of the mentions. Okay, so let us check the answer. Option C, unit ramp signal. Okay, why I am saying unit ramp means, because when we plot the graph for the given function, we get a straight line passing through the origin with a unit positive slopes. So the function is called a unit ramp signal. Okay, I will draw here. Just a minute. See, u of n equal to n for n greater than or equal to 0. So I will draw, plot the sketch for here. So here n, here u of n. Okay, for example, if n varies between 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Here also our n varies between 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, so u of n equal to n for n greater than 0. It means u of n equal to 0 means here the signal will start here in this point. Okay, I'll color it here in this portion. Next portion, if u of n equal to 1, when n equal to 1 means u of 1 which is equal to 1. When n equal to 1 means u of 1 which is equal to 1. Okay, so it means you plot like this. Okay, in this portion. In this portion. Next, when n equal to 2, you substitute here u of 2 equal to also 2. So when you plot this 2 region, so here. Okay, so next, when n equal to 3, so like this portion. When n equal to 3, this portion, so here. Okay, so your signal is said to be ramp signal. When n less than 0, so it is equal to 0, otherwise it is equal to 0. So this portion we call it as the ramp signal. Okay, so the function is called unit ramp signal. This is the correct one. Am I clear? Right. So the discrete time function u of n equal to n for n greater than or equal to 0 means ramp signal. Right? Okay. Next, you want to get signal. Like next question. X of n star del of n minus k. X of n star del of n minus k equal to dash. Okay. One common signal will be given. Then unit sample, that is delayed shift signal, will be given. Right, option A, x of n. Option B, x of k. Option C, x of k star del of n minus k. Option D, x of k star del of k. Okay, so the answer will be x of k star del of n minus k, because here the signal, it is defined only when n equal to k. Okay, so by the definition of delta function, x of n star del of n minus k equal to x of n is converted into x of k. So del of n minus k is del of n minus k. Okay, so this is the correct answer, because it is the definition of delta function. Okay, so x of n star del of n minus k, which is equal to x of k star del of n minus k. X of k star del of n minus k. This is the correct answer, because it is the definition of delta function. Okay, now x of n is transferred to x of k, but del of n minus k is also transferred to del of n minus k only. Okay, so option C is the correct answer. Okay, so next we move on to next question. A real valued signal x of n is called as anti-symmetric signal, that is non-symmetric signal, if dash. Okay, x of n equal to x of minus n. Option B, x of n equal to minus of x of minus n. Option C, x of n equal to minus of x of n. Option D, none of the mentioned. So let me check the answer. That is option B, x of n equal to minus of x of minus n. This is the anti-symmetric signal, because according to the definition of anti-symmetric signal, the signal x of n should be symmetric over the origin. So for the signal x of n to be symmetric, it should be satisfy this condition. Okay, see, I will draw it here, no problem. See, anti-symmetric. So anti-symmetric means, see this graph, this is x of n. Okay, so this is portion will be x of n, means here n versus x of n. Okay, anti-symmetric means you draw like this. Okay, this is anti-symmetric. Okay, here n varies between 0 to n. Here n varies between 0 to minus n. Okay, so here amplitude 1 means here amplitude minus 1. Okay, this is anti-symmetric. So this portion, it represent x of n. This one, it represent x of minus n. Okay, but here the amplitude is also minus, so I put here minus. So x of n equal to minus of x of minus n. So option B is the correct one. Okay, am I clear? Right. Next, we move on to next next question. Time scaling operation is also known as dash. Time scaling operation is also known as dash. Option A, downsampling. Option B, upsampling. Option C, none of the mentioned. Okay, so answer A is the correct one, downsampling. Because if the signal x of n was originally obtained by the sampling a signal x a of t, that is analog signal. You all know that the discrete time signal is obtained from continuous time signal only, isn't it? So x of n, which is equal to x a of n t, that is a t equal to n t times. So how you determine the sampling the continuous time signal means, see, x of n is your discrete time signal, which is equal to x a of t, that is, this is nothing but analog signal. Analog signal. Now at t equal to n t, at t equal to n t, so this condition only you can get the discrete time signal. Okay, when you substitute in this condition here, you can get the discrete time signal. Okay, now y of n equal to x of 2n, for example. Okay, y of n equal to x of 2n, say x a of 2n t. Okay, so here what do you observe this equation, the time scaling operation, that is x of 2n is the time scaling operation, isn't it? So it's equivalent to changing the sampling rate of 1 by t to 1 by 2t. It became 1 by t to 1 by 2t, that is to decrease the rate of the factor 2. So to decrease the rate of the factor 2, 2 times it will be decreased here. So the time scaling is also called as downsampling, because it is the decreasing the sampling rate. Okay, so that we call it as downsampling. So option A is the correct one. Okay, once again I will tell you, discrete time signal, it is generally, it is obtained from the continuous time signal at the condition t equal to nt. Okay, for example, if you take y of n equal to x of 2n, okay, if you take like this, so x of 2n, I substitute here x of 2n, okay, x of 2n, which is equal to xa of, okay, xa of, here at t equal to nt, no, at t equal to nt, so here instead of n, I substitute here 2n, so 2n, then capital T. Okay, so it means here the time scaling operation, this one is time scaling operation, is equal to changing the sampling rate. Here the rate will be changing here. It means one by t. So 1 by t can be replaced by 1 by 2t. 1 by t can be replaced by 1 by 2 times t. So here 2 times d, it means your sampling rate, that is changing the sampling rate. No, so the rate of the factor is decreased by 2. Rate of the factor is decreased by 2. So the scaling is also called as down sampling. Now you are all clear. Okay, next, I hope you are all clear. Next question, the output signal. Okay, the output signal, when a signal x of n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 is processed through an identical system is dash. Okay, is dash. Option A, 3, 2, 1, 0. Option B, 1, 2, 3, 0. Option C, 0, 1, 2, 3. Option D, none of them mentioned. So now x of n equal to the signal. The signal is can be processed by identical system. Okay, so what is identical system? An identical system is a system whose output is same as the input. That is identical. Your output is same as the input. So identical means whatever input you given to the system, your system can process it, your input, it can produce the same output only. Okay, same input only, right? So because output is same as the input, it does not perform any operation on the input. That is why we call it as identical. Okay, whatever input you given, the output, it will produce the same input only. Okay, so it, but because it cannot process it any input, any, it can process any operation. That is what we call it as identical. So 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3 means here what is that? C, option C. So the same input 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3 is the answer. Okay, option C is the correct one. Next question. If a signal x of n is passed through a system to get an output signal of y of n equal to x of n plus 1. So your system can perform this operation, y of n equal to x of n plus 1. Now the signal is said to be dash. Okay, this is your system. Let us say this is your system. Okay, this is your system, y of n system. Now your input is x of n. I will apply the input is x of n. Okay, your output is y of n. So y of n, which is equal to x of n plus n. X of n plus n. Okay, some operation has to be performed by the system. X of n is applied to the system, but your output is, you will get x of n plus 1. So what is it called? Okay, it is delayed sequence or advanced sequence or no operation or none of the mentioned. Okay, for example, the value of output at time n equal to 0. I will apply here at n equal to 0. Okay, what do you get? Y of 0, which is equal to y of 0, which is equal to x of 1. X of 1, or when n equal to 1, I will apply here n equal to 1. Okay, y of 1, which is equal to x of 1 plus 1, which is equal to, it become 2. Okay, it means here the system is advanced by 1 unit. Here the system is advanced by 1 unit. So 1 times it will get advanced, isn't it? When I substitute here at n equal to 0, it become x of 1. When n equal to, again I will substitute n equal to 1 here, you will get x of 2. When I substitute here n equal to 3, you will get x of 4. Okay, it means your output is, your system is advanced by 1 unit. 1 unit it will get advanced. So option B, this is the correct answer. Okay, advanced by 1 unit. Okay, advanced by 1 unit. Right, next question. The block denotes as follows is known as dash. So is it inverse block? You all already know that what are the blocks we required for to design the system, isn't it? So here is it inverse block will be given. So is it inverse means what? Delay, it, we call it as delay block or advanced block or multiple block or added block. So here delay block is the correct one. Okay, is it inverse, it represents delay element. So delay block is the correct answer, because if the function to this block is x of n, then the output from this block will be x of n minus 1. So 1 times it will get delayed. So the block is called delay block, or we call it as delay element. Okay, in previous one also, previous ones generally we mentioned delayed or advanced or no operation, none of the mentioned. Okay, but actually your answer is you get delayed by 1 unit. So it will be not advanced by 1 unit. This is not mentioned here. So option D is the correct one, not option B. Option D is the correct one. Okay, am I clear? Right. Next question. The system described by input output equation y of n equal to n into x of. So the system described by the input output relation y of n equal to n into x of n plus b into x cube of n is a dash. Okay. So option A, static system. Option B, dynamic system. Option C, identical system. Option D, none of the mentioned. So let us check with the answer. Output system y of n. So here the y of n, it depends only on present value of input, but not on past or future value of the input. So the given system is said to be static system. Static means what? Memoryless, isn't it? So static system or memoryless system. So option C, a static system is the correct one. Okay, let us check the answer. When n equal to zero, I'll apply here. When n equal to zero, okay. When n equal to zero, so what do you get? Y of zero, which is equal to n into, so whole term it becomes zero. Zero into x of zero plus b into x cube of zero. Okay. Suppose if I apply here n equal to 1, so what do you get? Y of 1, which is equal to, so 1 dot x of 1 plus b into x cube of 1. Or suppose I will apply the negative input here. So y of minus 1. So what do you get? So minus 1 into x of minus 1 plus b into x cube of minus 1. Okay, you just observe your input and output relation here. Your output is depend upon only the present input. Your output is depend upon only the present input. Here also, your output is depend upon only the present input. Here also, your output is depend upon only the present input. So it doesn't depend upon any past input as well as future value of the input. So the given signal is said to be static system. Am I clear? So given system is said to be static system. So option A is the correct one. So next question. If a system do not have bounded output or bounded input. Okay, clearly you read the sentence. Your system do not have a bounded output or bounded input. Then the system is said to be dash. Option A, causal. Option B, non-causal. Option C, stable. Option D, non-stable. So stable means Bibo concept. In the system, it will obey the Bibo. Bibo means what? Bounded input, bounded output. Okay. Here the question will be, your system do not have bounded output. So it means unbounded output or bounded input. So but your input is bounded, but your output is do not have bounded. It means your input is bounded, but your output is unbounded. So the given system is said to be non-stable. Am I clear? So if it satisfies a Bibo concept, we call it stable. If it doesn't satisfy this condition, we call it unstable. So here the answer will be unstable system. Okay, not stable. Next question. If x of n and x of k are the endpoint DFT pair, then x of k plus n equal to what? Okay, x of minus k, option B, minus of x of k, option C, x of k, option D, none of them mentioned. So x of k plus n, this is the periodicity property, isn't it? So properties of the DFT, x of k, which is equal to x of k plus n. So option C is the correct one. I will explain here. We know that x of n, which is equal to, according to the definition of DFT, x of n, which is equal to 1 by n summation, like this. You write down like this. X of n, which is equal to 1 over the period of n summation. Okay. So here k varies between 0 to n minus 1. N minus 1. Inside you write down capital X of k, because left hand side you have time domain. Okay. So e to the power of plus. So e to the power of plus j 2 pi k n by capital N. Okay, this is nothing but definition of DFT. Okay, definition of n pi DFT. X of n equal to 1 by n summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k e to the power of j k 2 pi k n by n. This is definition of IDFT, not DFT. Okay, IDFT, inverse discrete Fourier transform. Okay, definition of DFT is x of k, which is equal to 1 by n summation. Here you put x of n e to the power of, here you have minus j 2 pi k n by capital N. So here n varies between 0 to n minus 1. So this is the definition of DFT. This is the definition of IDFT. So here what do you get? X of k plus n. Let us take x of k equal to x of k plus 1 in this equation. X of k equal to x of k plus 1 in this equation. Okay. So what do you get here? X of k. Okay. X of k plus 1. So when you substitute here x power 1, n which is equal to 1 by n summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of k plus 1 e to the power of j 2 by k plus 1, which is equal to same answer only. That is x of k. So x of n. So answer become x of k is the correct one. Am I clear? So see students, this is your definition of DFT. Okay, don't get confused here. Only you take this answer. Okay. So instead of here k, I substitute here k plus n, k plus 1. Instead of here, I substitute here k plus 1. Okay, it means here x to the power of 1. So my answer became x power 1, that is which is equal to x of k. So x of k plus n, instead of 1, I put here n means. So here became x of k. Here became x of k. Okay. So answer is x of k is the correct one because it is nothing but periodicity properties of the DFT. Okay. Periodicity property of the DFT. Okay. See the question. So x of k equal to x of k plus n. So next question. What is the circular convolution of the sequence x1 of n equal to 2 comma 1 comma 2 comma 1 and x2 of n equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4? Find out the circular convolution of this two sequence. Okay. So option A is 14 comma 14 comma 16 comma 16 comma 16. Option B is 16 comma 16 comma 14 comma 14. Option C 2 comma 3 comma 6 comma 4. Option D 14 comma 16 comma 14 comma 16. Let us check the answer. We know that circular convolution of two sequences is given by the expression. So this is the formula, okay? So that is x of m, which is equal to, formula is x of m, which is equal to summation, okay? X1 of n, first sequence is x1 of n. You take down like this, x1 of n. Second sequence will be delayed sequence. That is x2 of m minus n. So that is n point. Am I clear? So here the limit changes from n varies between 0 to n minus 1. So this is the definition of circular convolution. Okay. Now we substitute this condition here. When m equal to, for m equal to 0, when you substitute here m equal to 0, what do you get? M equal to 0. So x of 0, which is equal to summation, okay, n equal to 0 to n minus 1. So here how many points will be given? 4 points will be given. So 4 minus 1, 3. So 0 to 3. Okay. So next x1 of here n. X1 of n. Keep it as it is. Next one is x2 of m minus n. M is here 0. So it becomes here minus n. Okay. At n point. So here n point means 4 point. At 4 point. Okay, x1 of n star x2 of minus n at 4 point. So when you expand this summation, what do you get here? When n equal to 0, now substitute here n equal to 0, what do you get? X1 of 0, first signal is x1 of 0, next x2 of minus 0. So it becomes 0 only. Okay, x2 of minus 0 is nothing but 0 only. Next plus, summation only, no? So I put here plus. So next samples, when n equal to 1, okay? When n equal to 1, not plus, you put multiplication only. So next samples, when you put here, next samples. Yeah, plus only. When you put n equal to 1, so x1 of 1, next x2 of minus 1. X2 of minus 1. Next, when n equal to x1 of 2, into x2 of minus 2. Next, n equal to 3, x1 of 3, into x2 of minus 3, Now you substitute the sample's value here. Okay, x1 of 0. Look at this equation. X1 of 0 is what? Here 0 is 2. 1 is 1, 2 is 2, and 3 is 1. So here also start from 0 to 3 only, not negative value. So the negative terms and all become 0. Okay, so every time is multiplied with 0, so it becomes 0 only. So first sample is what? 2. X1 of 0 is 2. So I substitute here 2. So 2 into X2 of 0. So here also 1. So 2 into 1, 2. So the first sequence is 2. Okay. Next. Second one. So your answer became, first sample is 1 comma 4 comma 3 comma 2. Second one is, which is equal to, for m equal to x2 of m minus 1. That is 1 times it will be getting shifted here. Okay. So it became, wait. So here answer became 2 comma 1 comma 2 comma 1. Okay, students, now I am showing this problem in graphical manner, so it is more easy for you to identify this answer. Okay, so first x1 of n equal to 1 comma 2 comma 1, 2 1 comma 2 comma 1. Okay, I'll draw one circle here. So this is x1 of n, right? So the circle, it represents x1 of n. Okay, here how many points are there? 4 points are there. So I marked as 4 points here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, equal points. So x1 of 0 is 2. I put here 2. Okay, then x1 of 1 is 1. So answer become 1. So here 2, here 1. Right, this is x1 of n circle. Right, clear? Similarly, for find out the x2 of n. 2, x2 of n. Okay. So inner circle, I will draw here x2 of n, x2 of n. Okay, here also equally marked into 4 points. Okay, so answer is here 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So now, as of now, right, so I will take this point in clockwise direction only. I will take this point in clockwise direction. Am I clear? This is also clockwise, this is also clockwise. Right. So, but according to our definition, when n equal to 0, if you substitute here, x1 of n multiply with the x2 of minus n, folded sequence only, no? So, first result will be x2 of minus n. So, now I am going to fold this sequence x2 of n. So, when I fold this sequence, that is x2 of minus n. X2 of minus n. So, I fold it like this. Okay. So here 1, 3, I keep this as it is, 1 here and 3 here, but I folded this direction, 4 to 1. So 4 comes down here and 2 will goes there. Okay, 2 will goes there, right? So this is folded sequence. So first condition what? When any m equal to 0, when you substitute here m equal to 0, x1 of n star x2 of minus n. So I draw here circle, one more circle here. Okay, I will draw one more circle here. Outermost circle, that is x1 of n. So here the point will be, first point is here in this place we have 2. In this place we have 1. So here we have 2. So here we have 1. So this is nothing but outermost circle is taken as x1 of n. So this is x1 of n. Okay, at when m equal to 0, your sequence like this. Right, let us take this inner circle, this one is outer circle. Now the marked point, now so here 1 and 1, 2, these two will be multiplied here, and these two will be locked here, and these two will be locked here, as well as these two will be locked here. Right, so now answer become y of 0, which is equal to 1 into 2, so 1 into 2, 2, okay, plus in this place 4, here 1, so 4 into 1, 4. Next, second place, 2 into, actually here you have 3, so 2 into 3, 6, 3 to 6, next plus, here 2, here you have 1, so 2 into 1, 2, so totally you add this point, so 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 6, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, so here you have the 14, so first answer we find out. Similarly, we find out the second answer. Okay, second one, I'm going to anti-clockwise this x2 of n in one tense. Okay, one tense anti-clockwise direction. So what you get, x2 of n here, one, no, now this one, actually you take this in clockwise direction, but one step anti-clockwise direction means, so this will comes here and this will comes down here and this one comes down here and this value comes down here, reached here. Okay, so I will take down like this, first signal x1 of n, x2 of n minus 2. Okay, x2 of n minus 2, that is n minus 1. So now your samples is here in this place, here 4 points, I will draw 4 points. Okay, so now this one will shifted here, no, so one will comes here, this four will shifted here, next this three will shifted here. Now here in this place you have two, this two will shifted at this point. Am I clear? Don't disturb the x1 of n, x1 of n you don't disturb it, so you just multiply here. So these two samples will be now multiply here, these two. So what do you get? So in this place you have two, here in this place you have two, so 2 into 2 it become 4. Next plus, so here we have 1, here we have 1, so 1 into 1 it become 1 plus, so here we have 4, here you have 2, so 4 into 2 8. Okay, plus, so here you have 1, here you have 3, so 1 into 3 it become 3. So what is the answer? So answer is 8 plus 4 12, 12 plus 1 13, 13 plus 3 16. So second answer is also right, 14 comma 16. Similarly, you find out the next two steps. Okay, next two step means here you shifted one time anti-clockwise direction, so now these two will reach at this point. Okay, so I will draw one more circle here, I'll draw one more circle. Okay, see what do you get? So these two, so these two will comes here, this one will comes here, this four will reach here, and in this place you have three, no, so this three will comes here. So now you just multiply these two signals. Okay, when you multiply these two signals, what do you get? So in this place you have three, here you have two, so 3 into 2 6, so 6 plus, okay, here 1, here 2, so 1 into 2 2 plus, okay, here 2, here 1, so again 2 plus, here you have 1, here you have 4, so 1 into 4 4. So you just totally add this all the 4 points, 6 plus 2 8, 8 plus 2 10, 10 plus 4 14. So third step also you got it. Okay, similar for fourth step. So now again you shifted this point as one step anticlockwise. So now what do you get? So this is your circle. Okay, so mark this 4 point here, so mark this 4 point. So now you take this one, so this three will reach at this portion. So now here you put 3, so here you put 2, here you have 1, so it will comes here. Actually here you have 4, so it will reaches it here. Now you just multiply these two signal. Okay, so what do you get? Here 2, here 4, so 4 into 2 8, so plus, so in this portion here you have 1, here 1, so 1 into 1 1 plus, so here you have 2, here 2, 2 into 2 4. Next plus, so here you have 3, here you have 1, so 3 into 1 3. You just totally add this all the 4 point, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 4, 13, 13 plus 3, 16. So your answer became 14 comma 16 comma 14 comma 16. I think this is the easiest for you, instead of to find out is mathematical representation. So graphical method is easy for you. This is nothing but circular convolution. Okay, circular convolution. So next we move on to, so option D is the right answer. Next we move on to next question. Okay, so next question is, if x of k is the n point DFT, x of k is a n point DFT of a sequence x of n, so x of n which is equal to x of k. When you take the DFT pair of x of n, you can get x of k. So what is the DFT of x star of n? Okay, x star of n. So option A is x of n minus k, option B is x star of k, option C is x star of n minus k, option D is none of the mentions. Okay, so according to the definition of DFT, when you take the x of n which is equal to x of k, so x star of n which is equal to x star of n minus k, x star of n minus k, so option C is the correct one. So according to the complex conjugate property of DFT, so complex conjugate property of DFT, we have x of k is the endpoint of DFTF sequence x of n. Then what is the DFTF x star of n is x star of n minus k, because it is the complex conjugate of the property x star of n minus k. Okay, note it down. This is the complex conjugate property of x star of DFT, that is x star of n, which is equal to x star of n minus k. Okay, option C is the correct one. Next question, by means of DFT and IDFT, determine the response of FER filter with impulse response h of n equal to 1, 2, 3 to the input sequence x of n equal to 1, 2, 2, 1. Okay, so you find out this sequence. Okay, option A 1, 4, 11, 9, 8, 3. Option B 1, 4, 9, 11, 8, 3. Option C is also given. Option D is also given. Which one is right? Option B. Let us check how it is answer B. Because the input sequence has length is n equal to 4. So input sequence 1, 2, 2, 1. So here you find out the length. Here length is 4. So n equal to 4. Impulse response sequence is 3. So m equal to 3. So according to the definition, length which is equal to, how to find out the length? L plus m minus 1. So 4 plus 3 minus 1. 4 plus 3 7. 7 minus 1 6. So totally 6 points will be given. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all these points are 6. So no problem. Okay. So next one more thing you want to check it now. Okay. That is, we know that y of k which is equal to x of k star h of k. Isn't it? Multiply sequence. DFT pair. Y of k which is equal to x of k star h of k. So we obtain this equation. Y of k which is, when you take the DFT of the sequence, y of k which is equal to, you get like this. 36, minus 14.3 something. So by applying the IDFT of the sequence, we can get this sequence. 1, 4, 9 like this. Okay, thus the output of the sequence is 1, 4, 9, 11, 8, 3. 1, 4, 9, 11, 8, 3. Where is it? Option B. So option B is the correct one. Okay, option B is the correct one. So see students, this is the definition of DFT. Okay, according to DFT, you find out this answer, x of k star h of k, you multiply this answer. Whether you have to take the, using the direct computation method or butterfly structure method. Okay, so when you use the direct computation method, you can get like this answer. Okay, 36, now this is your y of k, this is your DFT point. Now again, you are going to take IDFT. So when you take the IDFT formula, you can get like this, y of n which is equal to this answer. Okay, so your final answer is 1, 4, 9, 11, 8, 3. So better you follow the direct computation method. You know the direct computation method, y of k which is equal to summation x of k h of n minus k. No, so you're using this formula, right? So next thing is overlap add and overlap save are two methods for linear FER filtering of a long sequence on a block by block basis using DFT. Block by block basis. Option A, is it true? Option B, is it false? Option A, is it true only? Because in these two methods, the input sequence is segmented into blocks. And each block is processed via DFT or IDFT to produce a block of output data. So the output blocks are fitted together to form an overall output sequence, which is identical to the sequence obtained. Okay, the long block had been processed via time domain conversion. So overlap add and overlap save are the two methods for linear FER filtering of long sequence on a block by block basis only by using DFT. So block by block basis is the correct only. Okay, so next question, overlap save method for long sequence filtering, how many zeros are appended to the impulse response of the FER filter? How many zeros are added? So option D, L minus 1 zeros should be added. Okay, because the impulse response of FER filter is increased in length by appending L minus 1 zeros. And the endpoint DFT of the sequence is computed once and it will be stored. So how many zeros are added, appended? L minus 1 zeros will be appended. So option D is the correct one. Next question, in which of the following methods the input sequence is considered as shown in the following below diagram? Okay, so input signal will be given. Up to this block L, so this one is block LL. Okay, next M minus 1 zeros will be appended here. So this portion X1 of N, take it as the this one same portion X2 of N, like this M minus 1 here X2 of N, and you take above seek blocks. So here, as usual, okay, this is overlap save and the overlap add or overlap add and save, and none of them mentioned. Okay, from the figure, we can notice that each data block consists of last M minus 1. each data blocks. Okay, so first data block, let us take this data block. In last point, we have the m minus 1. So here also we have m minus 1. Here also we have m minus 1. Okay, so m minus 1 data points. The m minus 1 data points is the where this m minus 1 data points is nothing but previous data block, isn't it? Previous data block followed by the l new data points to the form data is equal to length n, which is equal to l plus m minus 1, which is the same as in the increase of overlap save method. So option A, that is overlap save method, is the correct one. Okay, see, this is your actual input sequence. I split up like this. So first sequence, I add m minus 1 zeros to this sequence, and also I will take the previous m minus 1 data points here. Next block, previous data block, whatever point I added here, I just added to this sequence, and also I will take down previous m minus 1 previous block data here. I just added together here. Next third signal, this signal will be overlapped here. Okay, then again as well as I will take down previous m minus 1 sample here. Okay, so this is nothing but overlap save method. Overlap save method. Okay, so next question: if g of n is a real value signal of 2n points, and x1 of n equal to g of 2n, and x2 of n which is equal to g of 2n plus 1, then what is the value of g of k, which is equal to k equal to n comma n minus 1 comma up to 2n minus 1? So option A, x1 of k minus w base 2 power k x2 of k, or x1 of k with plus w 2 power k then n x2 of k. X1 of k plus w base 2 power k x2 of k. Likewise, the option will be given. So given g of n is the real value 2n point sequence, then the 2n point sequence is divided into 2n point sequence, that is x1 of n and x2 of n. Okay, now let us take like this. X1 of n can be equal to x1 of n plus a complex part, that is j into x2 of n. Let us take like this. So when you take the DFT, it became x1 of k, which is equal to 1 by 2 x star of k plus x star of n minus k. Similarly for x2 of k, when you take x2 of k, it became 1 by 2 j, because it is complex form, so j x star of k x star of minus x star of n minus k. Here we put here minus. So we know that g of n, which is equal to x1 of n plus x2 of n, this is according to our definition condition. Okay, so now g of k, which is equal to, when you add these two value, you can get x1 of k, okay, minus w2 base power k into n x2 of k. This is nothing but k, when k equal to n, n minus 1 to n minus 1. So option D is the correct answer. Next question: how many complex addition terms are required to be performed in linear filtering of a sequence f of t algorithm, or how many complex addition terms are required? So n by 2 log 2 log n, or 2n log base 10, n by 2 log 2n, or n log 2n. So answer becomes option B, because the number of addition to be performed in f of t are n log base 2 then n. But in linear filtering a sequence, we calculate the DFT, which requires n log 2n complex additions, and IDFT requires n log 2n complex addition. So the total number of complex addition to be performed in linear filtering of a sequence f of t algorithm is here two terms now, so 2n log 2n. Okay, so when you take the DFT pair, it will take n log 2n. IDFT take n log 2n. So when you add these two, it becomes 2n log 2n. So option B is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. Okay. Next question: how many complex multiplications are required per output data points? Per output data points. Okay. N by 2 log 2n by l, or n log 2 base 2 then 2n by l, then n by 2 log base 2 n by l. None of them mentioned. So option B, because in overlap add method, the endpoint data block consists of l new data points and additional m minus 1 zeros. Okay, n l new data points along with m minus 1 zeros. And the number of complex multiplications required in FFT algorithm here, n by 2 log base 2 n. So the number of complex multiplication per output data point is n log 2 then 2 n by l. So okay, option B is the correct one. Next to the last question: decimation frequency f of t algorithm is used to compute h of k. Is it true or false? Okay, yes, of course it is true, because the endpoint DFT of a h of n, which is padded by l minus 1 zeros, is denoted as such of k, isn't it? So now the computations performed once via the FFT and resulting n complex numbers are stored here. So to be specific, we assume that d decimation frequency, that is DIF FFT algorithm, is used to compute the h of k. So this yield h of k is a bit reverse order, which is the way it is stored in the memory. So option A is the correct one. So decimation frequency algorithm is used to compute the h of k. Yes, of course, it is used to find out the h of k. Okay, so answer 2 is the correct one. Okay, so thank you, students. Thank you for watching this video. Keep on subscribe my channel. Okay, and just click the bell icon in this channel. You will get daily notification. Okay, thank you, students. Thank you for watching this.